on the illusionary hope that such is going to save Eskom from the current financial crisis. In 2015, the Minister of Finance then, Tlantlanene, he tabled the same bill, which was asking for 23 billion, and also asked for the conversion of a 60 billion rand loan into equity, which was the previous intervention of the state into Eskom. And all of these are made with the intention that it will lead to the stabilization of Eskom. And since the 23 billion request, there were a lot of conditionalities and commitments made here that that will be the last time we make an intervention in Eskom. But where are we now? Eskom is still in a debt of more than 400 billion rands. In the current financial year, it made losses of more than 20 billion rand. And now we're being asked to agree on the withdrawal of 59 billion rands from the National Revenue Fund to again give to Eskom. But there are far much more deeper crises in Eskom which the political leadership is ignoring. One is that there's a leadership crisis. We have got a chairperson of the board who is incompetent and has been appointed as an acting CEO. There is no stability in terms of the leadership of Eskom. But the bigger crisis that Eskom is facing is the stabilization of coal prices. The National Energy Regulator of South Africa, NERSA, has said that the coal prices must cost about 350 rands per ton. But currently, Glencore is supplying coal to Eskom at more than 600 rand per ton. And that is the case with the established coal suppliers. And you will never gain stability in Eskom unless you have stabilized the supply of coal prices. The other factor which is being ignored deliberately by the politicians is the power purchase agreements that Eskom expends more than 25% on primary energy costs on IPPs, but the IPPs only generate about 5% of the energy that is needed. There is no sense in terms of retention of the power purchase agreements in the manner in which they are designed currently. So let us now talk to what should happen. If we were to agree to a special appropriation bill, one, we must fire Jabu Mabuza as the chairperson and acting CEO and supplier of Eskom. He's a service provider of Eskom. He is incompetent. There will never be any changes that will happen under the stewardship of Jabu Mabuza. Two, we must stabilize the prices of coal to the NERSA acceptable and given levels. Three, we should fundamentally review the power purchase agreements with the IPPs. And Eskom should have, the new leadership of Eskom should have the autonomy to independently negotiate the power purchase agreements without the imposition from the Department of Energy or whoever is doing so. Because in many instances, the leadership of Eskom is not aware who has signed those power purchase agreements. That is what in the immediate should happen. But the other thing that must be looked into is that do not unbundle a crisis-ridden Eskom. You can't say that you have got a crisis that is defining this power utility and you want to break it down into three entities. That is just going to deepen the crisis. The other thing that must be done is that the state should establish an independent renewable energy division so that we do not fully depend on the private power producers to generate renewable energy. And then as a long-term or medium-term intervention, you should pursue nuclear energy, but in a fiscally neutral way. You can have a build, operate, transfer model that can have those that have got money build, operate, and then transfer later on to the state in terms of how should be. And then the other issue that must be dealt with is that you should assemble a highly skilled team to investigate the delays on the completion of Kusile and Mudupis. Because there is a lot of money that has already been lost there. There's no clarity as to when are we going to plug Mudupis and Kusile into the national grid. So we might need to then deal with that in the immediate. unless all these things have been dealt with adequately, the EFF will not agree to the continuous withdrawal of money from the National Revenue Fund to just throw into a sieve called Eskom. Thank you very much.